Welcome. In this video, we will look at DrChrono and Onpatient side by side to show the connections between the two. To begin, we'll look at inviting patients to Onpatient. You can invite patients individually through their chart by going to Onpatient Access on the left. And once we're in here, there's certain pieces of information that we need in order to send the invite. We need their social security number and email address, or we need their date of birth, phone number, and email address. So any combination of those two will get us there, and we can hit Enable Patient Access. You can also bulk invite patients to Onpatient by going to Account and Onpatient Settings and clicking Invite All Patients Now. This will send an invite to all the patients who have not yet been invited. We can also invite patients from the appointment window. I'm going to go ahead and schedule an appointment here, and I'm going to enter the patient's name. And next, I'm going to go down and click Save. The appointment is saved here. And next to the Edit Patient button, there is a little blue box that says Invite to Onpatient. So you can invite patients that way, provided you have the information on file in their chart that we looked at earlier. Once the patient has received the invite, it'll have this information here, and they just need to click the Sign Up Now button. This will take them to the Onpatient screen, where they will be prompted to create a password. Once the patient has created a password, they can click Sign Up. And they will be prompted to verify their identity with the information that we have on file in the chart, so either their social security number or their date of birth and phone number. Once the information is entered, the patient can hit Confirm and Connect, and that will take them to the Onpatient screen. Here, in order to have a patient check in for an appointment, we do have to have an appointment in the future, and they can just click Check In, and here they will be prompted to complete any onboarding information that you have set for them. The majority of the fields in Onpatient populate information from the patient's chart and vice versa. Under the Demographics tab on the top left, the Important Demographics and Insurances tabs will push and pull information from Onpatient to DrChrono, or from DrChrono to Onpatient. We'll go ahead and enter some information here that was not previously in the chart by entering a work phone number in here. And when the patient saves this information and completes their check-in, it'll populate in their chart. This next section, More Information, corresponds to the Custom Demographics section in the chart. DrChrono's custom demographics allow you to add data fields that can be specific to your practice that are not already included in Onpatient. You can go to Account and Custom Fields, and over on the left, we'll go to Patient Demographics. It's important to note that not all fields in custom demographics need to appear on Onpatient. You can see I have three selected that I have appear on Onpatient and one that I do not. To create a new field, click the green Add New Field button. At minimum, you have to enter a name. If you'd like it to appear on Onpatient, click the corresponding box. You can also make it required on Onpatient by clicking the corresponding box. The Additional Information section is one of two areas that connect to the form builder. These areas will populate the clinical note and not the chart. I'll start by going to Clinical and Form Builder. And over on the form list, there are two down at the bottom that say Onpatient Additional Info and Onpatient Reasons for Visit. The Additional Information section can be customized by adding fields from the form tools on the left. I'll go ahead and select a few pieces of information here. And once this information is entered, we'll be able to see it in the clinical note. Through the Form Builder, you can add, delete, or modify existing fields to capture the information that you need to better care for your patients. The Reasons for Visit section features switches in the Form Builder, but they appear as checkboxes on Onpatient, and they will be switches in the check-in app, just as a note. But patients can check the boxes, the information will be saved, and then they can move on to the next section. As patients progress through the check-in process, they will encounter the different sections that you have set up for them, or the sections that are part of the default Onpatient forms. I'm going to go ahead and pull back up Jenny Harris as our sample patient here to show you how some of these pieces of information can connect. So we can see we've got allergies on Onpatient, and this information pulls in from the patient's chart under the allergies section. Patients can note any changes to allergies, medications, or conditions by entering the information into the text box to be reviewed by the practice during the visit. These notes to changes will appear in the clinical note. The medications section will correspond to the medication section in the patient's chart. This will have any medications that have been sent through the system through a prescription, entered manually, or any data that has been merged through a data sync with SureScripts, or if you imported CCDA files with prescription information, that information can also be merged into the patient's chart for this list. The changes to medical conditions section corresponds to the problem list in the patient's chart. This list will have any ICD-10 diagnoses documented in DrChrono through a visit or entered manually. If needed, patients can note any conditions that have changed through the text box. I'm going to enter none here just so we can see what the information looks like on the other side of the visit. Insurance data entered through Onpatient will populate the patient's chart under the insurances section. Here, we can enter information. I'm going to add a plan name here and a group number just to have some information here. And if the patient is not the subscriber, they can uncheck the box and add the subscriber's information, and this will in turn pull that information into the patient's chart. The questions and comments section allows patients to enter any questions or comments they may have for you, and this information will populate on the clinical note. Finally, consent forms can be signed through Onpatient provided that they have been uploaded under Patients and Consent Forms. And here you can have patients sign consent forms that you have uploaded as PDFs, and you can make them required or assign them by default. You can see the two that I have here. To sign, the patient clicks on the form, and they'll scroll down and say, "I've read this document," and they will do that with any consent forms that you have here, any number. Next, they will add their signature, and they can sign with their mouse, click Save Signature, and once that's complete, they can click I'm Done, and this will bring them back to this screen, and they have completed the onboarding process. We'll go ahead and look at a patient's chart now that they've completed the check-in process. Here, we'll look at the information that we added for insurance, so we can see there is our test plan number and our test plan name. Under Clinical, Onpatient Forms, there are some settings that you can use to further customize the check-in experience. You can make fields required, you can hide sections, or you can also reorder forms. You can see how each section has the questions in each field. If we'd like to reorder the forms, we can go up here and click Reorder, and you simply drag and drop the sections into the order that you would like. So as we proceed, we can go down here, and if I want to hide a section, I just click the box that says Hidden. So for example, if I don't want the questions and comments section here, I just uncheck that box. And then I'll refresh, and here I can see that it's been taken out of the check-in process. Now, let's take a look to see how this information connects to the clinical note. I'm going to go to the schedule in DrChrono, and then I'm going to open up this appointment that the patient checked in for. And I can see that they checked in online because it says CIO in the top left corner there, and it'll automatically update that once they click the I'm Done. We can also see that there's the status there. I'm going to click View Clinical Note, and this will take me to the patient's clinical note for this visit, and I'll click on Onpatient Check-in Information, and here I'm going to go ahead and just click on Check-in in the Onpatient so we can see how these connect. And there I've got the additional information that was filled out, medications and allergies, so we can see the notes that I added here so I could review those with the patient. When we look at the reasons for visit, we can see that the answers checked on Onpatient will connect to the reasons for visit section here, so if those need to be reviewed with the patient, we can look at those. And we can also see the questions and comments that were filled out by the patient as well if we would like to discuss those with them. Once a consent form has been signed through Onpatient or the check-in app, it will live in their chart. I'm going to go ahead and click on the patient's name to take me to their chart, and I'm going to go over to Documents. Once in Documents, I can go to Signed Consent Forms. Here I can see all the consent forms that have been signed by the patient. I can click on a consent form name, And this will take me to a PDF version of the consent form that has been signed by the patient on an additional page. We can also use the Onpatient portal to send and receive messages from patients. To start, we'll go over to the communications section, and then we'll go to the blue Send Message button, and this sends a HIPAA-compliant message to the patient portal. We'll be taken to the message center where we can enter the information in, and from this point, it's just like doing an email. We can select any attachments and click Send Message. The patient will receive a notification in their email that they have a message from their provider. They will need to sign in to the patient portal in order to view it, and once logged in, they can view the message and respond. To do so, they click on the message, and then, just like doing an email, they click Reply. The patient can send back any attachments. If not, they'll click Send Message. Back in DrChrono, we'll receive a notification that we have a new message from a patient, and we can click on it and be taken to our message center and view the message. Let's take a look at how we can do patient statements through Onpatient. To begin, we're going to go to Billing and Patient Statements. From here, I'm going to search for the patient that I would like to send a statement for. I'll go ahead and type Jenny Harris's name in the search box. And then I'll select the patient and go over and click Update. Next, I'll select the checkbox next to the patient's name and go to the Actions menu and click Mail Statements. This will send the statement to the patient portal for the patient to pay. In order to set this up, we go to Account and Onpatient Settings. And then we'll go to the Communication tab. And next, we can check on the Send Patient Statements to Onpatient box and update our settings. Under the Billing tab on Onpatient, the patient will be able to view the statement and they can also pay, provided that you have set up Square to accept patient payments through Onpatient. Patients have the option of paying the full amount or entering a one-time payment. Here they can add a card if they need, or they can use a card that's saved on file. Patients can also make a payment using the Make a Payment button. Here they can enter one-time payment information. I'm going to enter a dollar. If they want to enter card information, they can do so as well. Or if there is a card on file, they can hit the Pay button, which is what I'm going to do. Next, I'll click Confirm, and it'll tell me that the payment has been made, and then I will click Done. If I want to view the payment history, I can go ahead and do so under Payment History. Back in DrChrono, we can go to the Patient Payment section in the Patient's Chart. And once we have this information, we can see the patient payment that was made. So in this case, we've got our example that we just made that was $1. Patients can also schedule appointments through Onpatient. To do so, provided that we have the setting enabled, we'll click Book Appointment. They'll select a provider, a location, and then they'll select an appointment time. And this information is populated from the schedule that is set under online scheduling in the office. Next, they'll put in a reason for visit and click Schedule. They'll be asked to confirm. And once that's set, they'll be prompted to complete the onboarding forms. Back in DrChrono, we'll go to the calendar and we'll look for the appointment that we booked through Onpatient. Here, you can see that we have a 30-minute appointment that was booked by Jenny Harris. If we want to make any changes to this, for example, how long the appointment is, we can go to Onpatient Settings, and then we're going to go to Appointments, and we can see we've got a duration of 30 minutes. So any appointment scheduled on Onpatient will be for 30 minutes. If you want to make any changes to that, you can do so here by entering a different time. In DrChrono, we'll get a notification in our message center that an online appointment was scheduled. So we can see that there, and it will correspond to the appointment that we have set in Onpatient. To set the online schedule, go to Account and Offices, and once you're in the office you'd like to edit, click on Online Schedule, and here you can see the days and times that we have selected. So once we click Book Appointment, we'll select the provider, the office, and here we can see the availability that we have based off the schedule that is set for the office. And again, the patient can enter the information and click Schedule, confirm, and then they'll be prompted to check in for the appointment. Thank you for watching our Onpatient and DrChrono side-by-side comparison.